This is a frequently asked question from Math 1530, Probability and Statistics, in Module 3. This problem is over binomial experiments, and let's read this question together. It says, 58% of men consider themselves professional baseball fans. You randomly select 10 men and ask if he considers himself a professional baseball fan. Find the probability that the number who consider themselves baseball fans is exactly 5, at least 6, and less than 4. Now before we go on, I want to talk about the calculator function that we'll be using to solve this problem. There's two calculator functions that will help us for binomial experiments. The first function is the binomial PDF function. It finds probabilities for x equals r statements. We will use this function for the problems that state exactly r successes. The other calculator function that we'll use is the binomial CDF function. This finds probabilities for x is less than or equal to r statements. So the binomial PDF stands for binomial probability density function. Binomial CDF stands for binomial cumulative density function. Now, let's go back to our problem and look at the solution. So for part A, we were asked to find the probability that exactly 5 of the 10 men who were asked whether or not they were baseball fans, that exactly 5 said that they are. So we recognize this is a binomial experiment and that the number of trials is 10, that the probability of success is 0.58, and we can use this binomial PDF function on the calculator. So on the calculator, what I'm going to do is use this function, binomial PDF. You have to be careful that you pick the one that says PDF. And you hit second, distribution. You can scroll down until you find the binomial PDF. I'm going to go up to PDF, hit enter. The number of trials is 10. The probability of success is 0.58. And we want exactly 5 successes. So I'm going to put 5 here, go down, hit enter. And we see that the answer is 0.216. Okay, so that's for part A. Let's go ahead and look at part B. Part B wants to know the probability of getting at least 6 of the 10 men answering that they are professional baseball fans. And we can see that we have the number of trials is 10, that the probability of success is 0.58. We recognize that this is a binomial experiment. Now on this one, we have to be careful because the CDF function will only find less than or equal to statements. So we're going to use this concept of the complement. We know that all probabilities are between 0 and 1 inclusive, and that the sum of all the probabilities must add to 1. If we look at all of the different outcomes that are possible for this experiment, these are all the individual outcomes. We could have exactly 0 people say that they are, exactly 1 person say that they are, exactly 2, and so on. We're asked to find the probability of a greater than or equal to statement, but the CDF function can only find less than or equal to statements. So if I look at this carefully, if I know the probability that the number of men is less than or equal to 5, if I know that probability, if I subtract that probability from 1, that will give me this statement, the probability that x is greater than or equal to 6. So algebraically, I've written it out here, we can see that the probability that x is less than or equal to 5 plus the probability that x is greater than or equal to 6 must equal 1 for 100%. And we can subtract this statement from both sides, and we see that the probability that x is greater than or equal to 6 is equal to 1 minus the complement, which is the probability that x is less than or equal to 5. So we can use the complement, probability that x is less than or equal to 5, and subtract it from 1 to get our greater than or equal to statement, the probability that x is greater than or equal to 6. We want to do this because the binomial CDF function can find less than or equal to statements, but it cannot find the greater than or equal to statements directly. So on the calculator, what we can do is write it this way. We write it as the probability that x is greater than or equal to 6 is equal to 1 minus the probability that x is less than or equal to 5. So on the calculator, I can do this all at once. Let me get the calculator pulled up. And I can start by saying 1 minus second distribution. I'm going to go down to the binomial CDF. Oops. I have to find the CDF function. Make sure it says CDF, not PDF. Hit enter. The number of trials is 10. Probability of success is 0.58. And the less than or equal to statement that the calculator is going to find is for less than or equal to 5. And go down and hit enter. And I can see that the answer is 0.582. So that was part B. Now we'll go on to part C. We want to find the probability that x is less than 4. We know that the number of trials is 10. The probability of success is 0.58. And we recognize this is a binomial experiment. And we're going to use the binomial CDF function on the calculator. So what I'm going to do is go back to the calculator, and since this is a less than statement, I don't have to do the 1 minus. So this is a strictly less than, so I'm going to go second distribution, go down to the CDF function, and the number of trials is 10, probability of success is 0.58. Now I'm going to put the x value as 3, not 4, because it says less than 4, so we want to include 3. Go down and hit paste, hit enter, and our answer is 0.071. And again, I want to mention that we needed to use the 3 in that statement for the function because the less than 4 does not include 4. And if you want to look at it visually, these are the possible outcomes for this experiment, and we're told to find the probability of less than 4, so that's 0, 1, 2, or 3, these outcomes, and that's what the CDF function finds, strictly less than or equal to statements. I hope this example helps everyone. Good luck.